Today's video is directed to those of you who feel like I need to get rid of some stuff. A few weeks ago, I uploaded a video called Why is Decluttering Difficult? Plus How to Make it Easy. And you guys gave me some really positive feedback on it. If you haven't seen it yet, you can find it in the description to watch after this one. But this really inspired me to make today's video, where I share 10 things you can easily get rid of right now that will really help you to cut the clutter in an easy and relaxed way. These 10 things are really easy to recognize, and for most of us they will hold no big emotional value, so it can be really easy to let go of them. Perfect for beginners if you're just starting out on your decluttering journey, to help you get into that decluttering mood and hopefully go on to tackle some of the more challenging areas as well after that. Or if you're just here for some inspiration, you're gonna get that too. You got this, let's begin. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It's always a huge help. Let's begin with the first. Okay, so yes, we're gonna go right into it with this one. Get out all your underwear and your socks and get rid of the old, the ones with holes in them, the ones that don't fit anymore, the ones that are uncomfortable, and the ones that you never wear anyway. It's gonna feel great, easy peasy. A lot of us hold on to old packaging or boxes that stuff came in, like the box for your TV or for your camera. I admit, I used to save these boxes too, until I realized that I never actually had the need for them and I saw how much space they took up. Getting rid of these will instantly award you with a lot more empty space if you have them lying around. Take a look in your kitchen cabinet. If you have so many different cups and bowls and glasses in there that you have to stack them on top of each other, that could be a sign that you could benefit from decluttering your cabinet. Really fancy glassware, beautiful espresso cups, really cute bowls with Japanese designs. These things are definitely on my weakness list too, but when I decluttered my cabinet, keeping only the ones that I really, really loved and used, it just made everything a lot easier. I've said it before and I'll say it again, most items you only need one of. If you have any duplicates lying around, see why you're holding on to them, and I suggest keeping the one that you love the most, which is usually the one that you use the most, and finding a new owner for the extras. Pens that don't work anymore, jeans that are beyond repair, that thing you always say you'll get fixed someday, but you never do, these things will just lie there, cluttering up your space, maybe even making you feel guilty for not fixing it. If you haven't fixed it over the last year, you're probably not going to anymore, and it might be time to say goodbye to everything broken. Number 6, old magazines. Be honest with yourself, you're probably never going to read them again. And they are great to declutter because they take up a lot of space and they are heavy to carry, so once they are gone, you will feel great. You might even know someone who would still want to read them, so there's a chance you will make someone else happy as well. I'm sorry to be the one to tell you this, but your dead plants are probably never going to come back to life, no matter how much you want them to or how long you keep them around. Get rid of them and make some room for a new one, or keep it empty. Our freezers are a place where lots of stuff always goes into but hardly ever comes out of. Be honest, if there are things in there that you're never gonna defrost and eat, or things that are more ice than anything else, give your freezer a good cleaning and get rid of the stuff. I personally love doing this one because it feels so nice and organized after. Go through the apps on your phone and delete the ones that you haven't used over the last 3 months. It will feel great, you will be able to find the ones you do use more easily, and it might even make your phone work faster too. Last but not least, sort through your cosmetics and get rid of all the ones that you don't use anymore. Dried up nail polish, that glitter eyeliner that you never actually use, make some room by getting rid of all the old ones. And again, this is a great opportunity to clean out the container you keep them in, which somehow always gets dirty. What are your tips and tricks for easy decluttering? Share them with me and everyone else who's watching this video in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear about your thoughts and experiences. If you want more, then I have 2 recommendations for you today. In this video, I share 7 minimalism tips for beginners, and in this one, I talk about some of the pitfalls of minimalism. And of course, if you haven't subscribed yet, then click this one so that I will see you in my next video. Take care for now. I'll see you next week. Bye bye.